Notre Dame is number one.
Notre Dame with a miracle win is a
He's going in! Notre Dame has scored!
But from the time I grew up, I loved this school. I heard about it. I read about it. I don't bring tears to my eyes very often. I'm not a particularly emotional person. And I thank God for giving me the opportunity to be here with you. I didn't come here to be a legend. I came here just like you and the rest of them to achieve. And I don't care what happens. If there's any way in this world to have great academics, we'll never sacrifice that. And win the national championship, we're going to do it this way. Thank you.
Lou Holtz's first game, there was a lot of anticipation going into it. A lot of people that weren't in the organization or in the football program were very, very excited to see whether the results would show themselves quickly or whether it would take a lot of time. Well, I think that game kind of validated that there was a new sheriff in town, so to speak. We went out against a highly ranked Michigan team. Jim Harbaugh was a quarterback, and we went out there, did not punt the whole day. Michigan had no idea what we were doing offensively. We lined up in the wishbone. We lined up in all kinds of different formations. We ran the option. We threw the ball more than any Lou Holtz team traditionally had thrown the ball, because that's what I did. And we had a guy by the name of Tim Brown on the outside who was a pretty good playmaker. So we ended up shooting ourselves in the foot. The only reason we lost that game was because we had three turnovers, I think, inside the 5-yard line. We also had a kicker by the name of John Carney, who had a fairly successful professional career. He missed an extra point that day, and I think he had a 35-yard field goal to win the game for us. There was also the famous Joel Williams catch in the back of the end zone.
Buerelein rolls it left, throws into the end zone, touchdown!
Oh, they said he was out!
To this day, all of us Notre Dame people will swear that he came down in the end zone, but the referees, there was no instant replay back then, the referees ruled him out of the end zone. Make a long story short, we lost the game 24-23, and I think as we were coming off the field, the fans gave us a standing ovation because they knew that the change was already begun at that point.
I'm proud of Notre Dame, I'm proud of it. Just one of those things. I feel bad for the players. I've been involved, but it was a great game. We made some mistakes, but golly, it was a great game.
We came in there, and we'd had a lot of really tough losses during the last 3 years of the Jerry Faust era, my first 3 years at Notre Dame. A lot of very disappointing losses, and some of those games we felt like we were just literally outclassed. And I don't mean that from the standpoint of we weren't good enough to win. I mean, we just went out there, and we came off the field saying, you know, we weren't even close to winning that ball game. I don't know what happened. They weren't that much better than us, but we got killed. Well, we came off the field after that Michigan game, and we felt that day in that locker room afterwards that we could play with anybody in the country.